The video you're about to watch is genuine footage from our investigations. No manipulation, no fakery, just real footage by real investigators. Viewer discretion is advised. Built mid-19th century, Hartshill Canal Yard features a blacksmith shop, stables, a cottage and clockhouse, a large family dwelling. The historical documents were destroyed in a fire, but there are stories passed down through the years. It is said that there was a tragic death that occurred in the clockhouse. The Lady of Clockhouse is said to have thrown herself down the stairs in grief after losing her daughter to illness. HBI were asked to investigate the canal yard due to staff experiencing paranormal activity in the house and grounds. Paranormal claims, apparitions, disembodied voices, and a negative presence in Clockhouse. This is the very first paranormal investigation of the yard.
Hi, I'm Gemma from HBI and we're investigating Hartshill Canal Maintenance Yard. As far as we know, it's one of the only investigations that has been done. And we are hopefully going to experience quite a few things tonight. There's been lots of reports of different types of activity, but even just setting up tonight, we've heard footsteps, we've had members of our team being poked down in the cellars, and we've had lots of things where people can smell pipe smoke, and that's before we've even started. So hopefully that's just the start of something great. And we're going to have a good night. So we're just going to go and do our walk round with Steve, our medium, to see what he can pick up in each of the rooms. And yeah, rock on.
Okay. So I'm Steve and John, the HBI team medium. And it's amazing that we've been granted access to this Hartshill maintenance yard. There's very, very little history about this place. Many records were destroyed in a major fire here some years ago. So really it's an unknown. There's very little on the internet about this place. There's just some pictures, but very little historically. So we're hoping that we can delve into the past and see what's here. It's a very atmospheric place. We've got a canal running through it, which gives it some atmosphere. We've got some beautiful buildings. This building in particular, we're guessing is Georgian by the style of it. It is absolutely beautiful. It's a pity that it's not in its former glory at the moment. It's a very large building. There are a lot of rooms in here. There's staff quarters at the top, which unfortunately aren't safe for us to go up to this evening. There's a cellar, which is really quite freaky. There's a very good atmosphere down there. We've been down there already. And I've seen a couple of spirits down there. So let's go inside this house and have a look around. So this property has quite a fusty smell when you walk in, as an old sort of damp property would have. We have had some interesting smells here tonight. Tobacco smoke, aftershave. Generally they do happen with spiritual activity. If Can you imagine over the years who's lived in this house, the sort of families and people that have passed through? Hopefully there's some spirits here tonight. Obviously there's a couple in the cellar. I have been here once before for a tour of this house, and there was a lady upstairs who I've also seen, so I'm hoping that we're going to have several spirits here tonight that are going to want to talk to us.
Active or residual spirit?
Active.
Okay.
Yeah. Obviously the flooring is very interesting. There's some the original flooring here. There's quite a few different styles actually. Obviously these blue and white tiles were probably put down in the 60s, maybe.
Yeah,
I've
then you've got the...
seen something like that before.
What looks like an original.
Gemma's hearing something.
I thought I heard footsteps up here then.
Okay.
Rob's next door, sitting up.
Yeah, but it sounded like it was.
And also when
up
I
here.
Shifted my weight, something did. Clunk underneath my foot on the floorboard as I shifted.
But it sounded, it really did.
Right.
Yeah, up that way.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, no, it sounded like a definite.
Was it in here where was Simon in here when he heard footsteps above him?
No, it was in the
next door.
Right.
This room doesn't feel so relaxing.
No. Are you hearing stuff?
No. I was just seeing where that beam went.
Okay.
Yeah. We go through into the... Okay, so we've got a kitchen. Probably would have been a pantry in there. And very interestingly, the cellar. Which I absolutely love.
The cellar's awesome.
Because it really doesn't feel very welcome when you go down. You want to follow me down? So, when I came down here about an hour or so ago to have a look around, there was a young girl down here, about 6 or 7 years old. She was quite playful and mischievous. And she'd actually poked Lynn shortly before. And there's also a man who came out of this room behind you, Lee.
Okay.
And I've seen him on other parts of the property this evening. And he looks like a real worker, very grubby face, sort of a cap on, dirty clothes. He's quite thin. So he, I guess, would have been one of the maintenance workers here. And he's not happy with us here. He's not threatening, but he's made it clear to me that he's not happy. He wants to know why we're here. So I guess this has been his space. He's probably been down here quite a bit. Connection with the girl, I'm not sure yet, whether they're connected. Okay, so we've got a lot of movement in this property. We've had several reports already this evening, so let's continue.
Okay.
Having a look
around. Have to be careful down here tonight with acoustics.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so we'll head upstairs. Quarters to the house upstairs. Unfortunately, the floor isn't safe up there, so we can't use that. Now we've got several rooms up here. A very large landing area. There have been reports in the past that somebody fell down the stairs and passed away. We don't know whether there's any record of that anywhere. There is a strange atmosphere in this area. It's quite heavy, I find. Another team members have reported that this evening. I've had a couple of people come to me and said, have I felt sort of heavy in this area?
in front of this window, like you've been pressed down.
Okay.
So it is interesting. We'll see if we can pick something up here. Okay, so front bedrooms.
Just before Steve started to talk, I thought
I heard two
noises.
Yeah.
One of them was the door.
One was the door.
Right.
As close as it just gone close.
Just oh, right, okay. I didn't see that. Right, yeah, okay, yeah. We've got to be careful of that tonight. Okay.
Okay, so let's go down. The side of the house is known as the cottage.
This is where a lot of people have smelt the pipe tobacco,
yes,
isn't it?
Pipe tobacco and the aftershave, which then suddenly disappeared.
And then it goes, yeah.
And we have nobody smokes in here.
Yeah, and we also have checked there's nobody with old style smelling aftershave.
And when I came through into this room earlier, there was a group of spirits in here.
That wall moves still really freely. Looks like little ghosts.
This is a very strange wallpaper. So we've had footsteps above.
Yes. Okay.
In here.
Well, some, I think Simon said he was in the kitchen area and it was above his head.
Another fireplace. And a pantry in there. Okay, there's a staircase which for some reason I find quite...
I don't like it. Don't like it at all.
Yeah, there's quite a foreboding feeling on this staircase, which I can't explain at the moment. So you pick that up as well.
Is there any chance that they could have got it wrong and actually someone's fallen down this staircase instead of the main house?
I would have said if anybody fell down the staircase and died, it would be
this one. Yeah, we're not sure.
This is... quite a large, to call it a cottage, it's pretty large, isn't it?
Mm, it is.
It's very kind of higgledy-piggledy.
Yeah, it's lots of twists and turns, yeah, in there.
So are you picking up anything in here at all, Steve, at the minute?
Not at the minute. It's just a weird atmosphere. Can't really put my finger on it. But I'm not currently seeing anybody in here. And we've got this box in the wall, which we're not sure what that was for.
That's cemented in there.
What on earth?
That's quite unusual, isn't it?
After Lee says, "What on earth?" the cam mic picks up on some kind of anomalous voice. This wasn't heard at the time and isn't a team member in or outside the location.
What on earth? What on earth? What on earth?
So that's quite unusual, isn't it?
It's almost like some kind of safe.
Yeah,
but at some point it was covered over with
wallpaper as well. So that's quite unusual.
Can you blame her?
But I know what you mean about the claustrophobic feeling. It really just does feel... I don't know if it's because of the decor isn't helping. It just does feel...
It's not very homely,
is it?
I'm feeling that there's somebody here.
Sorry, Lee.
Sorry.
There's somebody here somewhere.
What's up, Joe? Did you hear that?
Hmm. What was that then?
Hello? Is there anybody in this house with us? There's no need to be afraid. Must be very strange having strange men and women walking around your house. Not knowing what we're doing here. We're here to just come and have a look at the place and try and talk to you, communicate. We'll come back later on and ask you a few questions. And if you'd be so kind as to answer the questions that we ask, we'd really appreciate that. We're not here to disrespect or to mock. We're just here to find out a little bit about this place and about you. We're just continuing now to do the walk round with Steve at Hartshill Canal Yard. This is the first time we've been here, and I think it's the first time it's been investigated for its paranormal claims. And we're just heading into the blacksmith's area now.
Okay, so this is the blacksmith's shop that we're heading into. We've seen a lot of work done in here over the years. This place was built about 200 years ago, and it's where they maintained the canal boats and when they built the canal. So there's been a lot going on in here over the years, but this is it's an amazing place to do an investigation in. We've got all the equipment here, and the fireplace is just so original. Again, another interesting room to do a vigil in tonight. See if we pick anything up. It's just amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so that is the blacksmith shop.
You say amazing, I say freaky.
So go. Over here, this is actually the canal itself. Unfortunately, obviously, we're not able to go very far in here because it's dark and it's a bit risky. But it is actually possible to walk through into the dry dock in the daylight. And that would have been where the canal boats went, and there's a door above for lifting things up and into the workshop.
Can you give us a name? And why are you asking me if I'm your daddy? Do you not know where your daddy is?
Carl.
Tell me.
Stomach.
She's this girl's quite playful. She's in a pretty dress.
How old would you say she used to?
She's less than 10.
Right.
She seems quite well, she's very well dressed.
What period of clothing would you say?
Yeah, but it looks Victorian type.
Right.
Does she look like the same girl that was down in the cellar?
Yeah, she is the same girl.
Same girl.
She's
okay.
The same girl.
So from that, we could probably assume that this was before the house was split.
Yeah.
Because the cellar is in the other side.
It was like a mirroring, wasn't it?
Yeah, I heard it again.
I heard that.
Just after you said, was it the same girl?
It was like
a statement, yes. I heard something.
Yeah, I heard that.
It sounds like it's
from her out there.
She's trying to let us know she's here, because when it happened before, it sounded like it was down in between kind of you and
The team start to hear what sounds like disembodied voices coming from inside the cottage.
She's like skipping around us. I'm not going to
even try to do this.
She's skipping around the room. She's really quite happy. She's a really happy girl.
Come and talk to us, Rebecca. And tell us how old you are.
What was that?
That was movement.
It was movement.
And that sounded like it was next door. Rebecca, sweetheart, are there other people here?
She's between us. She's actually there between me and you now. The right of my right leg.
Okay.
It's gone very cold.
Okay.
I can feel up my arm.
We're in the blacksmith and we have Kate, Andrea, and Lynn, and myself, Rob.
Good evening. Is there anybody in here with us this evening? If there is, could you come closer to us, please?
That's me moving around.
You probably never had people like us that come talk to you before, and that's what we're here for this evening. Hopefully if there's anybody here with us, you'll interact with us this evening. To do so, could you walk towards that light in the middle of the room there? It won't hurt you. The closer you get, the more likely that you're here. It'll give a sound. Please don't be alarmed by it. It will indicate to us that you're with us. Could you do that for us, please? Please don't be shy. We don't mean any harm. Is there anybody with us that would like to communicate with us this evening? Anyone at all? You need to make yourself known to us if you're here, please. We've come with utmost respect for you. Please tap on something or move something for us. Don't be shy, we've been invited here because we've heard that you two exist here. You still stay around, and really we're here to find out why. Is it because you like it here so much? Come on, don't be shy, make us jump because if you move something it'll startle us, but we don't mind. Could you do that for us? Then at least we know you are here listening to us. Could you do that, please?
Sorry, sake of any audios, the team is in the cottage.
I just see people around the table. I'm not sure if the table's round or...
Now, I've gone colder in here than I was in that front room.
Yeah, this is where
it's what Lee says, isn't it?
It's freezing in here.
It is freezing in here. And then you have, I mean, that's quite a big window.
Oh, okay. So. I see something, Steve.
Cover doors are still open.
Right. Just
having a...
Did you...
A look.
Keep that one open on the top.
Where?
You know you opened one of the glass doors?
Yeah, I closed it because I thought somebody might walk into it.
I was going to say, because that one's shut.
Yeah, I thought, I could just imagine somebody in the dark smacking into it.
Oh, I wouldn't have that problem. That'd be fine.
She's still with us.
I can't see her any at the moment. I'm just trying to work out how the room used to look. I can see that there's this...
What the hell was that?
What was that noise? Look. I can see that there's this...
What the hell was that?
I can see that there's this...
What the hell was that?
I can see that there's this...
What the hell was that?
That's footsteps.
That's footsteps. Definitely.
Where are they coming from?
Upstairs.
They're always upstairs, aren't they?
They are. But the thing is, we don't know if it's here or next door.
Yeah, but we're the only people.
Is it something in here moving around, or is it something next door moving around?
Somebody's coming through there. Somebody's coming.
Is that?
This is an adult coming.
Is that you?
That's my baby.
Right.
There's an adult coming through.
Stomach.
Would you like to come through? Don't be afraid. I just saw a little line there as well. Not that one on the... Is there an alarm or something else here? Not that.
It's an audio recorder, mate.
Okay. No, it was on the ceiling, Lee.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Is there
No, there's no power in the house.
There's no power in the house, so it wouldn't...
No,
it's this should be
anything on. I saw that light.
But, yeah, I saw a light on this flash.
Yeah, there was a flash of that.
Yeah, but I actually saw... There's probably some sort
of...
There looks like a smoke alarm.
But I saw a light come through the passageway.
But if that smoke alarm's working, it should have a green light on it all the time.
Unless it's a battery backup thing that's just flashing.
Yes, yeah, they
yeah,
go.
Yeah.
So there was a light that just came through the archway.
What's the matter?
As I just walked forward then...
Oh, Christ.
There.
What was that? Why did I do that?
I don't know.
Steve feels like an energy has momentarily taken him over, forcing him to make an unusual giggle. This is a first for Steve.
As I just walked forward then... There.
What was that? Why did I do that?
I don't know.
I saw something red here. And that was really weird. And then it just disappeared.
There's a weird...
I've just seen something.
I just saw something over your head then. Whoa.
There's something behind me. Because I can feel something touching the back of my back.
There's a really weird...
What the hell was that? There was a flash of... Really bright flash behind Lee then.
I couldn't see it.
Just the edge of it. It looked almost like a cobweb.
Turn around, wait a minute. There was something going like that on my t-shirt.
Yeah.
God, it's cold in
here.
The light was literally behind your head.
And again, round this side now on my shoulder. And someone else take this camera, just in case.
Okay, is there somebody wanting to get our attention in this room? I don't think it's Rebecca. Bless her. Is somebody wanting to let us know that they're here?
That could be a car.
But the light that I saw was... It was here. About there.
I've just seen a flash on the wall behind you again, mate. And it's not a car.
I'm not sure whether there is a road or something back here.
It was too quick to be a car, Jim. That's the thing. It was sudden flash.
There is a back lane.
Yeah.
So I've been down the back lane in the car.
Alright.
Not like that.
Okay.
It's only like a single track road. There's a really weird presence in here. Somebody... I feel like...
Whoa!
What's that? What have we got?
There's something here.
There's something in the doorway.
There's something here.
I'm seeing cobwebby things
about. Round here, I've just seen that as well.
You know, like that cobweb translucent.
That's a car.
I saw that as clear as day.
The team leave a digital audio on the fireplace in this room. Throughout the investigation, it captures some very interesting audio. EVP, electronic voice phenomena. This included voices and whistling. These sounds weren't heard by the team during the investigation.
Is this the man that you saw at the door?
This second clip is video followed by the digital audio clip of that moment in the video. The digital audio clearly picks up what sounds like someone whistling a tune after Lynn speaks. The cam mic audio picks up on no whistling. This remains unexplained.
Are you going to cooperate with us this evening in any way, shape or form? really appreciate it if you would. Please don't be shy or scared. Really appreciate it if you would. Please don't be shy or scared. Really appreciate it if you would. Please don't be shy or scared.
That's my topic. There's a gentleman in the doorway in a suit. He's got a moustache, short, dark hair, sort of combed down very neatly, like he's put Grecian on it. And he is a pipe smoker.
Okay.
He's puffing, I can see him puffing on his pipe. He seems quite an important gentleman.
Do you see a light change then, Ben, in the little corridor?
Not on this.
Do you know what that aftershave smell might be with smelling? It's pomade.
Possibly.
Because I've used it in the past and it is quite blokey, it's quite aftershavey. Mm. It's when you said Steve's got his hair slicked.
Mm.
When you said it, I thought, yeah, that I think that's what that smell is. We keep picking up is his hair product.
Yes, it's slicked hair,
yeah.
Like Brill cream or Grecian or.
Yeah, it would be pomade because of the time.
Mm.
Yeah.
My
that's
throat.
Got a distinct manly smell.
Is that somebody's stomach?
Yeah, it's my throat.
Your throat?
Yeah.
Is this the man that you saw in the door? With the nice suit and everything and the slick hair.
Yeah.
Is he the one who probably has been trying to put us off coming around? Is he the one that's maybe tried to make us feel a bit uncomfortable?
Possibly. He seems quite... He seems nice. I don't get a feeling of nastiness from him or anything.
Okay.
So I'm not sure.
We're really sorry, sir. We're trying to work out who you are. So if you could talk to us
what
and tell us who you are.
What was that, Lee?
There was like a loud knock as if somebody had tapped the wall or something out there, or
that
was walking.
Wasn't my foot, was it, that one?
Do it again. No. No, it definitely come from out here.
Okay, if the man is still standing kind of out in that corridor area, can you tell us more about yourself, sir? Because I'm kind of imagining if you owned this house, you were probably quite well to do. So I'm going to call you sir. I'm going to be nice. Could you tell us your name? Can you tell us what time period you think it is? What king, queen was on the throne when you lived here? Did you have this house built? Maybe that's why you want to stay here.
If he had the house built, how does he feel about it being divided in two?
Yeah, but you're not happy about that. I'm not happy about it, and it's not even my house.
But
come on, talk to us. You don't have to be afraid of us. As I said, if you heard me talking downstairs, this is something you're not used to. You've never had this before, where people are actually asking you to do things. Asking to hear you, asking to feel you, asking you to walk around. You're probably used to people hearing and feeling you and not liking it. We want you to do things. So don't be afraid to show yourself. Don't be afraid to let us know that you're here.
So you're still moving. Oh, I think it might be slammed stomach.
That wasn't my stomach there.
Was it not?
No, wow. This man's got a stick with a gold knob on it.
Ooh. So you are quite well to do then, sir. Maybe you were a big businessman?
Yeah, he's got some influence, this man.
Okay.
I think he had quite a lot to do in the village.
Okay. If you could give us your name, that would be a fantastic start as to finding out more about this house, because we know that a fire destroyed a lot of the documents and the history of this house. But if you can tell us something about yourself, we might be able to do more research and find out more about you and find out about the house and get that documented again, because surely you want people to know about this lovely house. And it really is a lovely house.
We'd happily move in.
Oh yeah,
We'd make a few changes, but we'd happily move in.
Yeah.
We could be the HBI headquarters.
I'm being tickled on my arm.
I thought I heard a giggle just before you said
that. Yeah, it's the girl, it's Rebecca.
I feel that, I wonder whether they were trying
what?
To...
What was that?
What was that?
What was that?
It was.
I didn't hear that.
I did.
Oh, I did. Yeah.
Wow, that came from kind of there.
But also almost behind where that cabinet was.
Behind me.
Where
the
cabinet is. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, so I've just been outside with Gemma before we came in, and very clearly picked up a name, Eliza, which just was shouted into my head. I don't know if Eliza is somebody that lived in this house, or whether she was somebody associated with the canal yard in some other way. So we'll see what we pick up in here. So if anybody is with us in this room, please come forward. We have, in the middle of the floor, a very clever device. And if you walk up to it very closely, it will light up and make a noise, and it will show us that you're actually there. There's also a little ball on the floor that lights up if you move it. Yeah.
And there's a... what's the other
there's
item?
A teddy bear.
Teddy bear.
And there's another ball as well.
There's another ball as well, is there?
Yeah.
Obviously on camera you can see what's there, but it is actually, for our eyesight, very dark in this room, so we can't see very much at all. So if anybody who lived in this house or is associated with this house wants to come forward, do you like to stay around here? Rebecca, are you here? I think you are. Then there must be your footsteps then.
No.
I thought I could hear something a bit earlier. Okay, Rebecca.
Sorry. I heard what sounded like dragging.
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 Dragging, yeah.
Something being dragged.
Okay. It's... what the hell was that?
What?
I heard that. Yes, I heard that.
It's my
stomach. Did you not hear?
Yeah, I heard that.
I thought it was from outside.
No, well, there's nobody outside. Nobody would be walking around here. And it sounded like it came from out there to me.
It was quite clear.
Yeah.
Should we leave there for a bit?
Yeah.
Yeah,
we can
always
come
in a bit. Right, is anybody out here then? I keep hearing noises from outside the room, because you've not come into the room with us. Are you upstairs? Are we in the front room? We heard a voice earlier.
Are you in the cellar?
Oh. What's up, man? Someone just touched my ear.
There's no cobwebs or anything, is there?
I don't know.
Temperature's changing.
No, there's no...
The temperature's
can you see any?
Change now. Around here, I can feel it. I actually feel a little bit uneasy.
Yeah, I'm just thinking the same.
Something down there, male voice.
Wasn't me talking, was it?
It come right from down in that corner. I don't think it was, Mark.
I don't know what it said.
I mean, I can't 100% say it wasn't, but you must have spoke very, very quietly.
I was talking to Gemma for saying we'd get a feeling we'd be
followed. Followed from a distance.
Okay, then turn the light out.
Yep.
Oh, Jesus.
It's very dark. Can't see a thing.
Cold anyway.
And it's cold.
That's very cold.
Okay. So we know that we've had Sydney and Rebecca down here. Are you here now? Is anybody else with us? We used to come down in the cellar. Anybody here? There's somebody up that end. Somebody down there wanted to come forward. That was a car, I guess. I think there's somebody down there. Why don't you come out and show yourself? We don't mean any harm. We're just interested in who you are. Well, I know there's somebody down there. Come forward. Come and speak to us. I thought I heard laughter then, like.
See your breath, Steve.
It is cold down.
It is cold.
That's me breathing out.
Do you want to take some filming, Martin? Mm-hmm. Cheers, man.
Come on, if there's anybody down here with us, can you come forward? Come and talk to us. If the person who poked one of our teammates in the side earlier, feel free to come and do that again to one of us. Maybe pull our clothing. Apparently somebody likes stroking hair.
Oops, maybe.
I was going to say, it feels like someone's stroking my body there.
Well, there's not a lot of it.
I'll tell you about it. That's why I said hair, not hair. Look, the copper.
No, I've got it now. Now you've said that.
Bet there's tons of cobwebs up here.
I didn't notice many earlier, I'd say.
Yeah, there's some on my head.
Come on, come and talk to us. Tell us your name. Don't be afraid. There's nothing to be afraid of. Can you tell us why you're here? What does this place mean to you? Did you work here? Did you work on the canal? In the boats?
Somebody's coming.
I can hear movement coming down.
Somebody's coming from upstairs, from this floor up here. Yes, that whoosh was a car.
Mm.
Come down. We're in the cellar. Wherever you are. Is there somebody up there?
Come on, you don't have to be afraid.
I know you're there. Come down and see us, come on. I'm getting the impression this person is annoyed that all the doors are open up there. They want to shut the doors.
Okay. All the doors to the rooms?
Yes.
Okay.
The doors are open to the room, they're not happy.
Well, you're they letting the heat out, aren't you?
They want to close them. Ooh. They want to close them. Sorry, I lost my foot in there. They want to close the doors, don't you? Because we've left them all open.
Why don't you go and shut them then? If you don't like them being open, why don't you go and shut them?
Come on, you can close the doors. Was it your house?
As the team head up out of the cellar, they hear an anomalous voice from inside clockhouse. This is a loud male voice. The other team are in the stable area at this point. Also, the early hours of the morning and the remote country location make it unlikely to be contamination.
Well, actually, no, it would have been an argon, I would have thought. And by all the grease stains, look, yeah, I would say there was an argon there.
Yeah. Probably something along those lines.
Yeah.
Right, are we
heading upstairs?
What the
hell was that?
What was that? What the was that? Deep male voice.
I heard it.
Did you hear it, Mark?
Yeah.
You heard it, sir?
Did you?
Right, are we
heading upstairs?
What the
hell was that?
Right, are we
heading upstairs?
What the
hell was that?
Right, are we
heading upstairs?
What the
hell was that?
Was that deep male voice?
I heard it.
Did you hear it, Mark?
Yeah.
You heard it, sir?
Did you?
Let's head that way then.
I love the way Mike goes out with you first.
Come on then.
I can't see a thing. It's a nightmare with this, isn't it?
Isn't it? The thing is, when you lift it up, it just doesn't do anything.
I think we've just heard you. Can you shout again for us, please? So we know whereabouts you are in the house. Use your voice.
Okay, so it's nearly 3 a.m. and we're about to wrap up our investigation at Hartshill Canal Yard. It's been really interesting. We've had lots of different experiences, from people's clothes being tugged, hearing disembodied voices. Yep. Steve's picked up on quite a lot, so we'll have to go through all the audio and video and see if we've caught anything. But all in all, a really interesting place, great location, very historical, and we'll be coming back, I think. So